So like my first month as this program manager, I have people way older than me that I'm supposed to be supervising. And she's like, I need you to go in and give this person feedback. And it was basically saying, you gotta stop effing up in plain English. I'll never forget, it was a Saturday, it was my day off, and I had to drive to the program just to give feedback to drive home. So I drove there and the staff person goes, are you here to talk to me? I was like, uh-huh. And she goes, well, you know what? I quit. She's like, do you still need to talk to me? I go, uh-uh.
I had that discussion this morning with someone that's very high level in our organization, and it wasn't like I didn't have my own observation, so I couldn't say that firsthand I saw it, but I looked at many different points, over time, and said there's a general perception that this XYZ, and then the person said, I guess I could see why that is, and because the fact that perception so much influences whether other people will listen to your suggestions. I mean, right, because we're supposed to be consultants providing coaching and suggestions. So if there's a perception by multiple people about you and your behavior that influences whether people will listen to you, then it's probably a really good thing to hear it and take it. You might take it with a grain of salt, or you might be like, and you might even want to digest it for a few days. But I think the biggest factor, and I don't know how to operationalize this, and this is not behavioral science because I don't know if there is any on this, but the biggest factor, I've said many times, on people feeling like you giving them feedback and then you accepting it, and this is very ambiguous, is whether that person feels like you have their best interest at heart. Because literally, I know that there are people that say shit to me to criticize something I do, and they never once pointed out anything positive ever. So I think it's mean-spirited and it's not meant to make me better. Mm-hmm. Now, on the flip side, if someone points out 3-4 positive things and then they say, here's the thing you can be better at, they go back. I'm not saying be fancy with Sam or saying I hate that. Just like point out stuff, let them know that you're not doing the shit for some HR requirement. I always say that. Like, it's not a human resource requirement. This is just one person or another telling you like, hey, this will make you better. I want to see you get better because it makes me look. Sometimes you even have to say that, make it selfish. Like, this shit makes me look better. Like, it sounds very selfish, but you want them to believe you that you really have their best interest at heart.
Right.
Yeah.
Because there's a big difference between someone telling you shit and they have no history of reinforcement with you, and they're out to get you, and they're like kind of mean-spirited. I don't know how to operationalize that. I've been part of organizations where it's true. They actually create a paper trail to find some. There's a big difference between what I suggested to Billy, where even the language and how you speak about it and how you, my covert actions about it are like something, one thing you can do better to make you better is a lot different as on a schedule and part of the survey than it is to find something wrong and criticize in order to have a reason to fire.